Welcome
back.
Talk too much.
Now, you are now a judge on Nigerian Idol. Okay, how did that go, this role that you had as a judge?
It was very interesting, but I kept asking one question with Jeffrey Daniel. If you don't set up an aftermath for all these people you are producing, you are just complicating the fake industry we already have. So you have the winner, you are not producing their songs, you are not producing a video for them, they have no record companies that can sign them. It's a waste of time.
What do you mean by fake industry?
Because the industry, Nigerians believe we have an industry. We don't have an industry. We have an entertainment, what should I call it, section or sector. An industry means you have record companies. So you have scouts. You have people that in the industry, in a record company, probably you have an A&R man who they look at you. Oh, you are a great singer, but you can't write songs. So you will find somebody who can write songs for you. You are a great instrumentalist, but you cannot write music. They will write the music for you. So industry is, oh, you have a particular tone in your musical instrument or your voice. Oh, you are probably best in going towards reggae or hip-hop. That's industry. Then industry goes deeper. You must be able to read and write music. Now we have computers. What do you know about the computer? Industry is, like I said, I want a bassist in America. I can give you nothing like probably 5,000-10,000 bassists that are
accomplished.
They can play anything. Then you have, in this same industry, you have those that don't like to be seen. They are like the studio rats. They don't like to show themselves in public. But they are fantastic bassists or guitarists or trumpeters in the studio. Now, because you have to understand, distinguish between playing live is very different from being in the studio. The studio is very sensitive, and the studio is like you can perform magic. You can start throwing sound up and down, where you cannot do this live.
So now, this assessment is at odds with the sort of popular belief out there, which is that our music industry is now doing fantastically well. We've got young rising stars whose music is being played in, you know, all parts of the world. You hear them in clubs in Europe.
Yeah, which is a very frightening trend, because what are these young boys and girls going to do when they become 40, 45, 50, when the next generation comes and start to produce? Because like I said, it used to be every 10 years that the life changes. Now it's like, then it became like every 5 years. Then it was like every 2.5 years. Now it's like every year, a new batch of, a generation just comes and says, this is their star. This is their this. They want to do it their own way. They have their language. The way they talk on Twitter is very different.
Now,
so it's very scary that these people, if they are not well trained as musicians, what will they do? Because why is Fela important? Because his music meant, he was talking about things that are very still relevant today. If, assuming we had electricity, Fela probably would still be relevant, but they would say, oh, he'll be more of historic facts. And then maybe because he was playing great music. But he's still very relevant because we still have no electricity, blah, 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 blah. So he becomes more relevant today. Why is Miles Davis relevant? Because he found a tone with his trumpet that nobody could produce. Why is Dizzy Gillespie important? So these are people, these are icons that they can never die. Likewise, you have in the classical music world. Why is Stevie Wonder? You see, America will guard Stevie Wonder, not just because he had a great voice. He was is an accomplished composer. He has won 24 Grammys. These are things that they put in the industry and they keep like an egg.
They protect.
They protect. It's the part of the industry. We are producing stars that don't know any musical instruments. Maybe they have a great voice. They are not writing the songs themselves. They have to go to this producer, and they are probably using the same producer. So the producers are really becoming the great composers, and they just use this person for this. So when they fight this producer, they can't produce another great song. So they just have a great name. That is why we need great schools. We need academies. We need music schools that will groom the young people to become great musicians, great singers.
You recently did a collaboration with Wizkid.
Yes, and many others too.
Well, which one else? Which, because it's the only one I've heard about.
I've done with Durella, I've done with, I can't remember all their names. I've done with Olumente. I did one, my first one was even with Weird MC, long time ago in the 90s.
Why then do you take the trouble to work with this?
Because they are
musicians.
Good people. They want to act. It's not their. You see, when I'm very critical about what they are producing or what. Their songs are nice songs. They are very danceable. But I fear for their future. Nobody's preparing the young people for old age, for their retirement plan, for when nobody wants to.
So your advice to the Davidos, the Wizkids, if you can, is now basically look and improve yourselves, learn an instrument, pick up something,
before it's too late,
and learn something.
Because there will be a time, and Nigeria is a very good country for that. Where today you are going to be the idol of everybody, and tomorrow nobody wants to listen to you. Everybody goes through that in their career. Fela went through that. You become, the ice cream of everybody, then suddenly you are just one bitter pill for whatever reason. The whole world, there is no artist. Everybody goes through the ups and downs in this life. You must go through that.
Now,
and probably God
government
wants you to go through that to make you stronger or whatever. But if you are not prepared for that rainy day, you are going to be in trouble.
The federal government, I understand, has some sort of entertainment fund, which is supposed to be money that is supposed to help improve the industry. Have you heard about this fund? Are you a party
to
the way it is going to be spent? No, it's a serious, a genuine question.
Before the government should go there, they should even talk about more serious issues. Healthcare, electricity.
So you think they shouldn't give any money towards promoting the industry?
I'm not saying they should not give any money. They should deal with the basic problems that we are facing right now. We have been trying to get electricity in this country now from when I can remember. We still don't have constant electricity. Government should first fix that. Let us know we have electricity. Don't let me go crazy. Give me electricity first. Then let's have health care. Give our doctors their due. Give our professors their due. Put our universities where they should be. Build our roads properly. These are things. Then, you see, music and all this are secondary as far as I'm concerned. They are more important issues government should be.
This is something central to your life that you are calling secondary.
But if I am sick now and I don't have a doctor to treat me, that means I'm going to die. If I'm sick now and there's no hospital to go to, I'm dead. If you don't farm and I am hungry, is it my music going to feed me? Music for me, art for me is secondary. It's my profession, but I will never put what is more important than my profession before. We need to farm. It's very easy.
There are people who will argue that the arts generally, and music is one of those, are things that are very important for even developing the mind.
I want to ask you one question. Go and play your instrument without food.
I don't play an instrument.
I'm telling you now. You want me to do, and I won't eat. It's not possible. So, you need all these important structures in place for good music. When you have all this, then when you have all these structures in place, then you will produce the greatest music on earth. Do you understand where I'm coming from?
Yes.
Then the music goes with the farmer. The farmer will even want to go to the farm, like our ancestors will have been doing. You'll be going to the farm singing, you'll be farming, you'll be singing. The music will give you enthusiasm. The doctor will be ready to operate because he just listened to good music, maybe coming to work on the radio, blah, blah, blah. Music enhances society. Yes, I agree. But if you say music comes before, I don't agree because they are
How about side by side with?
Yes, side by side in a good country where you have already established all those factors I've talked about. Good healthcare, good education. Okay, you want to talk about good music when your child is not educated? You want to talk about music when Boko Haram is killing our people? You want to talk about good music when there is robbery? You want to talk about music if all our youths were taking drugs? Where is the music when we can't sleep at night? Music will not be relevant.
It's time for another quick break. When we return, we speak to Femi about being Fela's son and his rumored romance with superstar Alicia Keys. Don't go away.
You may wonder why I switched to layer milk. Well, I got to look after my fitness trainer told me about the good stuff inside. You should try it.
Exercise and making good nutrition decisions like drinking calcium-enriched Loyal Milk every day is vital because it helps you nourish your bones and body so that you can live a more active life every day. That's why I encourage my clients and ensure that my family gets their Loyal Milk too. So, make that switch to calcium-fortified Loyal Milk because it's what's inside that matters.